Okay guys, in this video we are going to discuss about the normal form or perpendicular form of a straight line. What is that? Normal form or perpendicular form of a straight line. See, what is that normal form or the perpendicular form? First of all, you draw that figure. See here, this one is that xy plane. This one is that xy plane. This is that x-axis, this is that origin, and this one is that y-axis. Right? Suppose if a line L is meets the coordinate axis at A and B, meets the coordinate axis at A and B, and you draw the perpendicular from origin to this line. Let N is that foot of the perpendicular from origin to this line. Now here we consider that the distance of ON is that small p. That means P will be represent that perpendicular distance from origin to the line L is equals to 0. And here that ON is that makes an angle alpha with a positive x-axis in anti-clockwise direction. Then what do you say that normal form of this line? So to find the normal form of this line, we should know that A point and B point coordinates. So why you are called the normal form? So here that the normal to that AB, what is the normal to that AB? ON. Okay, this length is that a small p, and ON is makes an angle alpha. Now in terms of alpha and p, if we reduce that equation L is equals to 0, that is the normal form. That equation will becomes that x into cos alpha plus y into sin alpha is equals to small p. This one is that normal form. Okay, now first of all we will write that what is the definition of the normal form. See this one here, the straight line. Upon which the length of the perpendicular from the origin is a small p, and this normal, here normal means what? ON. This normal makes an angle alpha with a positive direction of x-axis is a, so what I said this one, x into cos alpha plus y into sin alpha is equals to p, is a x into cos alpha plus y into sin alpha is equals to p. So this one is that normal form of the line capital L is equals to 0. How will you get this one? Here this one is that A point coordinates are p into cosecant alpha comma 0, and B point coordinates are 0 comma p into secant alpha. By using that 2 points formula, we will get this one, right? So here is that how you are getting this value. If you find that OA length by using the triangle ONA, right? From this triangle, you will be get that OA length. And by using this triangle OBN, you can find that B value, OB value. OB is equals to P into secant or P by cos alpha. So according that we will be get these values. Okay, right. So all of you see this one. This one is nothing but P into cosecant alpha comma 0. Here is that P into this one is that cosecant. This one is that 0 comma P into cosecant alpha. This one is that P into secant alpha comma 0. Where? So what is that? P is equals to perpendicular distance. Distance is always that positive, where P is that greater than 0. Right? This one is that normal form of the straight line. L is equals to 0. Okay? Right. Now we will do the problems related to this concept, normal form problems. Okay, now you see this problem. In this problem, if the straight line x plus y is equals to 1 changed into the form x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equals to p, then what is that alpha value? Right, so how can we, that means what is the meaning of this one? This expression is called normal form of this straight line. This expression is called normal form of the straight line. So first of all, you see, how can we find this one? This one is that the given equation is that x plus y is equals to minus 1. So to convert this one into the normal form, you have to divide on both sides with the root of a square plus b square. A is equals to 1 and b is equals to 1. Then it becomes that this value is that 1 by root 2 into x plus 1 by root 2 into y is equals to minus 1 by root 2. Right? So now the right side value must be always positive. Why? Because in the normal form, that right side value will be represent that P. P is that perpendicular distance from origin to this line. So If we have that negative sign on the right side, you multiply with the minus on both sides. That implies minus 1 by root 2 into x plus minus 1 by root 2 into y is equals to plus 1 by root 2. Now this equation is normal form. So you compare to find the alpha value, you comparing this one and x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equals to p. Therefore, this one is that cos alpha is equals to x coefficient is cos alpha. Here x coefficient is that minus 1 by root 2, right? So comma y coefficient is the sin alpha. Sin alpha is equals to, this one is also minus 1 by root 2. We know that fundamentals in trigonometry, sin and cos both will be the negative in which quadrant? In third quadrant. In third quadrant, only the tan and the cot will be positive. Remaining all will be negative. So this one you can write that. So therefore, for what that angle, this one is that a positive, this one is that, so pi by 4. So therefore, alpha is equals to third quadrant means 180 plus theta. So that means pi plus pi by 4. So that is equals to 5 pi by 4. So your answer will be nothing but what? So third option is the correct answer. 5 pi by 4. And one more thing, in the same problem, if sometimes you may get that what is the perpendicular distance from origin to this line. So that is that what, after reducing into that normal form, the right side value is that perpendicular distance from origin to the line. So here is that P is equals to perpendicular distance. P is equals to perpendicular distance. Perpendicular distance from origin. This value will be equals to what? That is equals to 1 by root 2. So this one is the perpendicular distance. Right? I hope that everybody understood the concept of a normal form and how to do this solution. Right? Now we will see the one more question in this model. See, in this problem, x into cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equals to p1 and x cos alpha plus y sin alpha is equals to p2 will be the perpendicular. Perpendicular means what? Product of their slopes is equals to minus 1. We know this formula from the lower standards. So that means, I mean, from 9th and 10th standards, everybody knows that if the two lines are mutually perpendicular, product of their slopes is equals to minus 1, right? So according that, now you see this one, here this value you can write that, first of all, both expressions are in the normal form. Both expressions are in the normal form. So here this one we can write that, I will give that one formula. If two lines, a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equals to 0 and a2 into x plus b2 into y plus b2 into y plus c2 is equals to 0. C2 is equals to 0 or perpendicular or perpendicular. See, then the condition is a1 into a2 plus b1 into b2 is equals to 0. So this one is that condition if the two lines are perpendicular, right? So how will you get this one? The product of the slopes will be equals to minus 1. By using that formula, we can find one result when the given equations are in the linear form. Now in this given problem, a small mistake is there. So here this one is that cos beta and this one is that sin beta, right? Right, now you see this one. The first equation we consider as ax plus by plus c. Second one as that ax plus a2x plus b2y plus c2. This is a1x plus b1y. Now apply this one. Therefore, cos alpha into cos beta plus sin alpha into sin beta is equals to 0 according that above formula. Now it is in the form of cos A cos B plus sin A sin B is equals to 0. From this you can write that, you know, from trigonometry, cos A cos B plus sin A sin B is that cos of A minus B. So alpha minus beta is equals to 0. Let it be alpha minus beta as that theta. So cos theta will be 0 for what that angle? 90 degrees. So therefore alpha minus beta is equals to pi by 2. So here in this both equations, here alpha and beta, in one equation alpha is the angle made by the normal with the positive x axis, and beta also angle made by the normal with the positive x axis. In these two angles, which is that greater, we doesn't know. So according that we can write that modulus of alpha minus beta is equals to pi by 2. So or we can think in the another way is that cos theta is equals to cos of minus theta. So either cos of alpha minus beta is equals to 0 or cos of beta minus alpha is equals to 0. From that we can write this value. So what is the correct answer? B is the correct answer. Okay. So this is the solution of this problem. Right. Thank you for watching this video. If you like, please subscribe this channel.